The public went into panic after the National Council for Higher Education declared over 2,000 programs taught at 47 public and private universities in the country expired, deeming a good number of undergraduate and graduate courses pursued at these institutions null and void.
The Ministry of Education should, in conjunction with the Attorney General, come here over that issue.
During today's Parliament sitting, members of Parliament registered grave concerns on the matter, wondering the implication of the directive to students and parents.
We need more attention as a Committee of Education to look at this matter very seriously, Mr. Speaker. The minister will come here tomorrow. He has been on radio talking a lot of falsehood. He's not aware of what is happening. So the committee has to take a deep investigation in what exactly is happening and taking place in this expired courses.
I am pleading with you that this time you order the substantive Minister for Education to be the one to speak to Parliament. Because the Honorable J.C. Muyingo is a very obedient person, but he cannot be the one to bring statements all the time, especially on matters that are very serious.
MPs noted that the development has embarrassed the country to the core by foreign universities rejecting admission of Ugandan graduates for postgraduate courses.
It is a huge embarrassment to Uganda that foreign universities are rejecting Ugandan degrees. And much as a colleague, the Honorable Swalirwa, would require that the Attorney General comes here. There is no need. The culprits are known. The truth of the matter is that the statutory regulator of this sector is the Council of Higher Education.
The chairperson of the Parliamentary Committee of Education and Sports, John Twesije Ntamuhira, has vowed to summon the National Council for Higher Education and other stakeholders.
I would appeal to Ugandans, especially our young people, not cry tears and get worried. It's unfortunate that some people have been rejected at some universities. As a committee, we are going to try to investigate and find out what the problem is, and we shall find a way out.
Tayewa has tasked the Ministry of Education to make a clear government stand to avert this situation and also assure Ugandans that indeed those who are educated have valid degrees and, if not, offer a solution.
Issues of colleagues, let's talk on issues of National Council, because these are issues which I've said the statement is coming. So let us not submit in anticipation. Let the statement first come, and then I'll give you time.
At least 2,260 programs are listed as expired on the National Council of Higher Education website, leaving the fate of tens of thousands of current and former university students hanging in balance. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.